Also, thank you organizers, Bernd, Professor Bernd, and Sir, and Onita. Especially thanks to the Dr. Lee. Thank you. Please write on. I will use the whiteboard a little. First, I motivate my talk with this symplectic manifold. Especially to solve the Arnold conjecture, maybe long history, topologists and geometer work on symplectic manifold to study some proof Arnold conjecture. Symplectic morphism, fixed point set, fixed point, number of fixed point is greater than sum of Betti number, something like that. In symplectic manifold, we talk on two-dimensional sub-manifold on 2n. So we consider the two-dimensional Riemann surface, some genus G represent some homology class, two-dimensional homology class. Actually, some two-dimensional homology, integral homology class, they consider two-dimensional homotopic group. There are Hurwitz homomorphism is here. Then image is we called H2SM. This is image of Hurwitz homomorphism. They consider all we already mentioned. This is has a almost complex structure, and two-dimensional manifold all has an integrable complex structure is here. We consider this kind of map representing this homology class, the set of all holomorphic map, almost holomorphic map. We consider this moduli space. And we want to compactify on this moduli space. So we consider only stable J holomorphic maps. And with this compactified moduli space, we consider Gromov-Witten invariant. And also we consider from this Gromov's invariant, we can define the quantum product in some sense, generalization of our co-product in the cohomology group. From this quantum product, we have some quantum homology group of M with some Novikov ring with coefficient in Novikov ring. We have some this kind of new extended cohomology ring with this product. Then also from this product is associative. So from this associativity, we have a very good recursive numerical equation to find the number of J-Hermite curve. We have some nice recursive function. Also, from this Gromov-Witten invariant, also we can consider Gromov-Witten potential. There are many theories, Dubrovin, Konsevich, many other people. Work, especially in Japan, Fukaya, that person also consider this kind of thing all time. Also, another approach is here. This is a quantum cohomology. Also, we actually flow cohomology. They consider the loop to the M, 2N, simplex manifold, contractible loop. So that all contractible loop on, so all if XT is here, X is in here, then we can extend X tilde because this is contractible. Inclusion, we can extend it, X tilde E to the 2 pi it is just xt, like this. Boundary, on boundary, x tilde is like this. Then we can, there are many extensions here, x tilde. Many, we can get a relation, x1 over x2. x1 and x2 is two extension. Then equivalent means x1 tilde connect sum minus x2 tilde boundary sum is homologous to zero in h2 xm. Like this. Then we have this covering space. For each x, we have this kind of extension. The set of all extension is here. Their relation is equivalent class. We call this. This is infinite dimension in general. Also, H2SM is acton here, also. H2SM act LM tilde to the LM tilde. If A is here, x tilde is here, then natural x tilde sum a like this. So you can from this action and the quantum cohomology, we consider two-dimensional homology class in here. We can relate. Also, from here, we can do the Moses theory, so-called action functional from L tilde to R. Everybody consider action, Moses function also. This is infinite dimension. This AH X U, we call this is U, maybe X tilde U also. We call like this. Action functional like defined like this. U T2 U star fullback minus some also we for the this action functional also we can consider the Hamiltonian action, Hamiltonian periodic Hamiltonian HT plus 1 is HT like this Hamiltonian action functional. So for this you can relate the 0 to 1 HT XT DT like this. XT is here, HT is here. Also, we can, from this Hamiltonian, we consider Hamiltonian vector field. Hamiltonian vector field. Hamiltonian vector field is defined like this. XT is DHT like this. Hamiltonian vector field. Then we also from this Hamiltonian vector field. This Hamiltonian vector field is lives in level set. Then the solution of this Hamiltonian vector field XT, this is a differential equation of a Hamiltonian. Solution of this equation give rise to the some simplest morphism to M to the M D over DT PT is like XT. XT like this, Hamiltonian vector field. Then the set of all singular point, critical point of action functional. Action functional is from here to R, action functional, critical point of this action functional. This action functional is a critical point is some critical point is one-ton correspondence with some periodic function specifying this equation. You can compute this dAh x tilde equals 0 specifying this one. So critical point. And we consider gradient flow downward from AH, gradient flow of AH. We can consider this kind of thing, gradient flow, like this. Then we can get a flow cohomology from critical point of this simplex action functional. From this gradient flow, we can get some boundary operation. Mose Witten complex critical point, gradient flow we consider. From this critical point index is we know the index at the critical point. And downward, if this index is difference is 1, then we have a one-dimensional moduli space. But translation is invariant, so we can get if you cut the x, y downward, x, y is dimension 1, then we consider the translation invariant identify. Then we have a zero-dimensional compact manifold. We can count. From this count, this number, we get some boundary operation. Almost same. But in this case, this index of from some f, usually x minus index of f y is 1 if some this Mose function to m to the r, then we this gradient flow give rise to a boundary operation, Witten's boundary operation. In here, we have a loop is here, critical, this in downward, that's a loop. This is, in some sense, this is a cap of, like this. Why? We consider the loop is here. This is some x to the u, like this. So, from this boundary operation, gradient flow, you see the gradient flow of this simplex action functional give rise to a J-holomorphic map. J-holomorphic map. So, in this case, for this, we will define the detailed thing. This is Maslow index. This is Maslow index. I will define the Maslow index. What is Maslow index? And also Maslow index y tilde. This is x, y, then x tilde. Sum is y tilde, like this. Then from this, co-complex chain of co-complex, we get a flow cohomology of M with some Novikov ring structure in here. Novikov ring structure here. Also, you see the action, this action is on here. We have ring structure here. Also, in simplex manifold, many people consider the quantum cohomology and this Frau cohomology is isomorphic. We can give a detail how we correspond with this from quantum cohomology and Frau cohomology. Then this is all simplex manifold his story. But in this workshop, many people work on almost contact manifold. Many people almost contact manifold 2 and plus 1 like this. If many people work on Kera manifold, then M is N plus 1 Kera manifold, complex truck, complex manifold. Then many people work on this hypersurface of this hypersurface. X is 2N plus 1. In general, this for regular value, then usually X 2N plus 1 is some real hypersurface of this. This is odd dimension. This is Kera manifold. Kera manifold is a simplex manifold. This is special case. This is a special case. This is not in general. This almost complex is not integrable in general. So another example. So we can consider this kind of thing, almost complex, almost contact man, complex, almost contact metric manifold, co-symplectic, also contact, Kenmoch, the another structure I will introduce. Important thing is this has also, we can consider this real hypersurface. Also, all n-dimensional simplex manifold and Kera manifold, simplex manifold, then S1. This has almost complex structure, almost contact metric manifold also. M, Kera manifold, product 1, is this is almost contact manifold. All has almost contact structure. J square is minus identity, tangent space, minus plus zeta, like this. Former speaker, Professor Zhou, already mentioned almost contact structure many definitions, so I will skip this thing. We have this manifold. If this is almost contact metric manifold, then tangent space is all decomposed like this. Like this. On this two-dimensional manifold, fiber is Cn. And on this almost, this contact structure, this is square is minus 1. This is a complex manifold, complex vector bundle. So also consider the C1 on D. C1 is important to study the Gromov-Witten invariant. Also contact structure, we have a complex structure here, almost complex structure here. If almost complex structure is integrable, then we can consider Sasakiya manifold, the other things. Also normality we can consider. also metric is very simple. G, X, Y equal just projection. Neta X, neta Y. Just projection on here. And we get metric is here. Just projection on here. The other part is zero, so you see the this neta X product, neta Y, like this. Metric is this. If we metric and this thing, we have a natural standard two form, you can. X, Y is G, X, P, Y, like this. This is this function like a simplex structure on this complex vector bundle. So we need this is closed non-degenerate two form. Simplex manifold is closed. Non-degenerate, this is n dimension, this is non-zero everywhere. This is non-degenerate. So we need for this fundamental two form, we closed, we need. Almost contract structure is all, this is zero. Why? D neta is like this. This is almost complex structure. So DD is zero, all closed form. Also, co-complex structure is D neat equal zero, D cushy is zero in this case. So we can use the contact manifold and co-complex manifold and cannot is different. Not in general, D is not zero. In Kenmoch manifold, this is not zero in general. So symmetric sum of neta and pi. So we can, I will introduce C manifold. C manifold is not contact manifold, not co-complex manifold, not Kenmoch manifold, but DP is zero, another class. In this case, in C manifold, almost contact structure, and co-simplex manifold, in this case, we can do the Gromov-Witten type invariant we can define, we can do. Also, quantum type product we can do also. Quantum type cohomology, quantum Gromov-Witten type potential we can do. Also, we can do the Flow theory. You see the Flow theory is in, we all, in here, in manifold, there are some contractible loop. Contractible loop is like this. Critical, like a critical point of LM. Downstairs, then we consider gradient pro, this. This gradient pro is related to the J Hornby curve, Cauchy-Riemann equation, so-called. Perturbed Cauchy-Riemann equation, we can do, if you do the, this is a very special case, this is a contractible loop is just one point, then this is a critical point. Then, actually, they prove like using like this. This critical point has an index. In that case, is Moskowitz index, and critical point Mose index is a little different. Difference is n. Then we can define the usual cohomology. Usual cohomology group tensor, some ring, our knob coupling tensor like this. This is just quantum cohomology of this M to the knob with the coefficient in knob coupling like this. So this is really topological with coefficient knob coupling. This proves Arnold conjecture, actually. You see this is a Betti number of this is a number of critical point is greater than the number of Betti number. You see the what is the construction of cohomology? We all you know the old Moses theory. Critical point. We consider index. Like this. Then we consider the if this index, we consider cohomology or co-complex or co-complex or complex like this. If it is K plus 1, like this. This boundary map is, I already mentioned, this is the counts the gradient flow. That is a defined boundary map. That's very natural, very physical. From this index, if this is N plus 1, then N, you see this is index N plus lambda plus 1, this is lambda. Then what is this? This is just unstable. This critical point has an index lambda plus 1, then is unstable manifold. Unstable manifold is this is lambda plus 1 dimensional manifold. In this case, index is this is unstable manifold on this part. This part has some small neighborhood d. If this manifold dimension n is like this, d n minus lambda plus d lambda. This is unstable part. This is stable part. Like this. This gradient flow downward like this. This is a D dimension. This is coming down like this. This is N minus lambda many disk. Product is a whole disk DN like this. This flow this D lambda plus 1 t lambda counts the gradient flow of this with the orientation. That gives a boundary map of cohomology. So this is topological, really topological things. So we want to do this kind of closed two form and J holomorphing J almost complex structure on the distribution. Also, we can consider integrability. Do you know the integrability of Nijanius tensor for this? X, Y is a two form, X like a Lie bracket, we defined like this. Just like this. If this is we call this is zero, then phi is integrable. So in that case, almost Sasakian, almost complex, co-complex, co-symplectic, co-symplectic, almost co-symplectic, that kind of thing, very natural thing. We can do all this. I prepared my lecture here. I can see. Thank you. I did first introduce something, and I introduced almost contact metric manifold already. Professor Cho mentioned that kind of definition. And the quantum type cohomology I will introduce, and the plural type cohomologies, and finally, quantum and forward type cohomologies, I will do that. Abstract, you can see the, we want to study the relation, quantum type cohomology and forward type cohomology on almost contact metric manifolds with some, with a closed fundamental two form. Closed is important to integral. First, for quantum type cohomologies on manifold, we introduce pseudo holomorphic, pseudo co-holomorphic curves, modular space of pseudo co-holomorphic curves, representing two-dimensional homology class and the Gromov-Witten type invariant, quantum type invariant on quantum type product on cohomology groups, and Fourier type cohomologies on the not only also Fourier type cohomologies on co-symplectic manifolds. We studied already. I published some papers. Symplectic type action functional on the universal covering space of the space of contractive loops. The critical point of the functional, action functional, and critical point of the action functional, and the modular space of gradient flow line joining critical points induced this modular space and the critical point induce the co-chain complex produce Fourier type cohomologies. We extend Fourier type, we studied already on co-symplectic manifold. We want to extend the Fourier type cohomologies on more general almost contact manifolds, and show that the quantum type cohomology and the Fourier type cohomology are naturally isomorphic. As an example, we deal with contact manifold, co-complex, co-symplectic manifolds, C manifolds, and the product of symplectic manifold and contact manifolds. I already mentioned symplectic manifold and contact manifold is some C manifold. We will see the details. And the product of symplectic manifold and C manifold. This is C manifold. So we will give an explicit example and introduce the theory. So already mentioned the symplectic structure and the almost complex structure. To introduce the symplectic case, I want to introduce the theorem. Omega is tamed mean like this, satisfying for all non-zero vector. V rotated 9 degrees, then the symplectic value is greater than 0, it is tamed. Then the moduli space, J homomorphic curve, representing this integral homology class, we denote moduli space MAJ. Dimension of MAJ is like this. We can do the Atiyah single index theorem. To compactify, we use the some stability. We compactify to define the some Gromov-Witten invariant on M. Using the Gromov-Witten invariant, we can define the quantum product. Then we have some quantum cohomology ring. This is a vector space. Also, quantum product is here. So we have a ring structure. Some technicality is to count the some number, we assume the semi-positivity. At first, for the other concept prove the theorem on positive case, then extend some other people semi-positivity. Some formal condition is here. So LM is already I mentioned LM is contractive loops. LM, the set of all contractive loop covering is LM tilde like this. Extension U is extension of X. Two extension is equivalent means like this. I already mentioned. Then two-dimensional homology class act on the covering space by act like this. Action functional, symplectic action functional is this, the infinite dimensional space to the R is action like this. By definition, this is for this action functional, the critical point of AH is satisfying this ODE. This XT is Hamiltonian vector field. XT is a curve. So for the Hamiltonian vector field, this is a solution, integral curve. XT is integral curve. Then the closed, this is, I think, skip this is, the gradient pro of the AH, simplex action functional, is defined like this. Maybe this is R2. R2. And the satisfying this equation. This ST is U is defined on the disk. R2 on R2. This is you see the U is two variable, S and T. Partial DU along S, J. This is equal to zero. This is a Cauchy-Riemann equation. You see the already mentioned J minus J XT is a gradient, negative gradient pro of the AH. Negative gradient pro. orthogonal to the level curve. You see that. If this this is R2 greater than the pro is if S is go to infinite, then X plus. If S is minus infinite, then X minus. Two critical points joining X plus to X minus. U is join the project is an image projection of AH, critical points projection of the downstairs here. So the critical point for a connection orbit determine the cohomology complex, co-chain complex Cf star delta. We can define delta square is zero, then we have this kind of Fuller cohomology. I already mentioned the many people work around this. In simplex case, if MW is a semi-symplectic, positive symplectic manifold, then for some regular good H and J is there are ring isomorphism here with this ring isomorphism is this is a coefficient has a in Novikov ring, also this cohomology has a coefficient in Novikov ring, this ring isomorphism linear over this. So in section, we will introduce, in section two, we recalled almost contact metric manifolds, which is co-symplectic or contact and the C manifold structure with, and introduced symplectic manifold, product of symplectic manifold and almost contact manifold. Even dimension manifold, odd dimension manifold. They you have many different almost contact manifold. Also, product of almost contact manifolds. Sometimes they symplectic, sometimes not symplectic. So we can do this kind of thing. In section three, the pseudo cohomomorphic curves in almost contact metric manifolds with closed fundamental two forms and Gromov-Witten type invariant, quantum type invariant we introduce. And in section four, in simplex type action functional we introduce similarly on the universal covering space of the loop space of contractible space in the almost contact metric manifold. Using this action functional, we introduced the Fuller type cohomologies on almost contact metric manifold. In section 5, we investigate the relation between quantum and the Fuller type cohomologies on almost contact contact metric manifolds with closed fundamental two forms. The three case is a special case with closed fundamental two forms. This is important. So in almost contact we have our goal is introducing this theorem. Almost contact metric positive, semi-positive manifold has this manifold, if this manifold is co-symplectic, contact or C-manifold, then there are quantum type cohomology and Fuller type cohomology for regular value. For this, you see the regular value, this this regular value means H is a Hamiltonian, M to the R. Hamiltonian, this is a gradient pro is a Mose function, and that gradient pro satisfying Mose-Smale condition. You see the Mose-Smale condition is a transversality in infinite dimension, Mose-Smale condition. And pi is a regular means the generic almost contact structure, almost complex structure, generic. Generic means the derivative of Cauchy-Riemann equation is onto, generic means. Then the moduli space is the moduli space has some manifold structure to compute the invariant. We had a manifold and compact. Then we have some good invariant. Regular means. Then they have isomorphic like this. As a module of a Novikov ring. The isomorphism is a Novikov ring isomorphism. The special case, we will give some special case satisfying with the condition semi-positive and co-complex, co-symplectic contact and C-manifold. The case we give an example on here, 2.2.2. Then that case is quantum type cohomology and flow type cohomology is isomorphic. We already explained regular means this is some Mose-Smale and DU is the derivative of Cauchy nonlinear Cauchy-Riemann equation for the section that is onto regularity in some sense. First, I will skip just mention is order dimension, almost contact manifold, this one-on type tensor, this one form, vector field, satisfying this, and this is compatible with almost complex structure with G. I already mentioned this here. Then we also have this kind of two-form. Two-form is, you know, the anti-symmetric. This is non-vanishing. So all contact, almost contact metric manifold is some orientable. This is non-vanishing on M. M 2M plus 1. Form is here. Also, integrability and normality, you already know this kind of thing. There are many definitions here. Co-complex, sometimes this is almost co-complex. This is co-complex, sometimes use this integral and co-complex. But I use this definition. Co-complex, contact and normal in this case, this is zero. This is d pi is zero. So in this case, this is zero. So d pi is zero. So Sasakian integral, almost Sasakian. Is Sasakian Kenmuch C-manifold. Is C-manifold normal and this kind of thing. We will see the example
maybe skip. Maybe for the product, we define the metric and the two forms like this. Then this manifold has a this by computation d pi is zero, d neta is not zero, so not co-complex. This is d neta equal not equal to pi, so not contact. So this example is C manifold. Also, we can get many product to give an example. Product natural structure, almost complex structure, metric. Then, if we define like this, then we have an almost complex structure like this, J square equal minus. So we have an almost complex manifold with this even dimension. Also, if we compute the two-form, Fanon's two-form, then we have this kind of thing. So d neta, d pi is like this. If neta and pi is co-complex, then this is complex. D pi is zero. Then we have some property for the product space. And some example. In some, this is simplex manifold, and M2 is a contact manifold, then that is a C manifold, not contact manifold. C2 is a contact, then C manifold, then M is a C manifold. M is a simplex manifold, M2 is a co-complex, then product is a co-complex. So we can do many things. So maybe I can speak. Quantum type cohomology. And we should be careful. We only consider complex vector bundle. D is a distribution, orthogonal part of pi, Cauchy. Then we can complex, for the complex vector bundle, we can consider this kind of dimension we have. The co-complex structure for almost the modular space of stable J homomorphic pi co-holomorphic map. Then we have many property is here. I already mentioned many, I published papers. In that paper, we modular space dimension and the quantum type cohomology, we have quantum type cohomology groups. And MI is almost complex structure, then if M 1, 2, product is simplex, K-Larian, not, this is not symplectic. Both M1 and M2 product is not symplectic. M1 is co-symplectic, M2 is contact, then this is not, in general, not symplectic. Product is there are many properties. Also, for the product, we have a quantum cohomology decomposed like this. Madrid space is like this. If you use the Kuenin theorem, you can decompose the two-dimensional homology class like this. If A3 is inside by using the Kuenin theorem, in this case, it is very simple. You see the this is just usual cohomology of torus. Quantum cohomology of product is decomposed like this. I will skip many things. Also, we skip. Yeah. For the Olmos contact manifold, contact metric compact manifold, in this case, we have some property here. This kind of also quite important. Du C is if J is a J co-holomorphic map, then the image of the derivative is inside the should contained in the distribution, this kind of thing. So we can compute the dimension of modular space. We only use the small quantum product. So three marked point, we use just three marked point of the modular space. Then we can compute the to define the Gromov-Witten invariant, you can give some evaluation map and define this kind of Gromov-Witten invariant. Then, using the cobordism, we can get this kind of Gromov-Witten invariant is invariant on the almost core complex structure, P0, P1. We can get computer using the cobordism theory. So we can also define the Gromov-Witten invariant. We can define the quantum product. So we have a quantum cohomology like this. Then this quantum cohomology is associative ring under the this quantum product. Oh, and also we can do the all Gromov-Witten, we can use the Gromov-Witten to define the Gromov-Witten potential, not just three Mach point. Mach point is M is a positive all number. Here. Also, from this potential, we can get many relation, like a concept. Maybe I can skip. Yeah, we can get to define the quantum product. We can do the dimension computation. And for the product, we can do the Gromov-Witten potential. This is a very beautiful product structure is here. So we have this quantum cohomology. This I will go to the polar homology. Maybe you are interesting this thing in the Hamiltonian function, periodic Hamiltonian Hamiltonian vector field, Hamiltonian differential equation is simple ectomorphism And I already mentioned this space acton here, like this. Also, we have the Hamiltonian tariff action functional that if you define, if you compute, you have this equation. Then we see the critical point of simplex action functional is one-ton correspondence with critical loop solution of one is Hamiltonian differential equation. You can use the Fourier connecting orbit, some critical point, the other point connecting orbit. Using this modular space, we can define the boundary map. Using this, I already mentioned Novikov ring act on the modular space, the co-complex like this, and the boundary map is defined like this, co-boundary map. This is the number of modular space I already mentioned. We have a co-boundary map is here. Delta square is zero. So we have a Fourier homology, co-homology. Then we this theorem is independent choice of there are many choice of Hamiltonian. H alpha, H beta, many choice of almost co-complex structure. Then this kind of, we have a isomorphism satisfying this relation. So generic choice of phi H and phi, we can define the flow homology, will define. Quantum cohomology and maybe I keep almost I have, but you have this theorem, this flow cohomology and quantum cohomology. This relation is very very interesting. So I already mentioned, but you can see the, if you're interested, you can see the proof, this Fourier homology, cohomology, quantum cohomology is natural and natural isomorphy, ring isomorphy. Actually, we didn't mention the product of Fourier cohomology. So-called pairwise pinch product is here, product. This is Gromov-Witten product is here. The large pi is preserve the structure. So ring isomorphism actually, in this case, he only mentioned as a vector space. This is a module. This is isomorphism, actually ring isomorphism. Maybe I will stop here.